But I kind of got tired of the limelight. I didn't want anybody asking me any more questions about it. Every day, there's young men thought they could pull down on me now and make themselves famous. So I had to kind of look over my shoulder every day. That kind of took me out of town. I left Springfield and went north. Went over to the, I was going to go up to the Missouri River, but I ran into General Custer. He took a liking to me, of course, when I was in the service, and his wife took a liking to me. And I didn't like to converse with her. She was a good conversationalist, and we had a lot of good conversations. And they had me out to their tent. They'd cook up some meals for us. I'd eat good. One time he had a Senator Wilson in there come in, needing a scout, and they recommended me, and they said they'd give me $500 for a couple of weeks' work. So I took him, Mr. Wilson, his wife, and a couple of their boys, and took an Indian scout with me, and I scouted, and showed him the buffalo herds, which was looked like millions. Back then, we had so many buffalo roaming in the plains, back there on the Kansas border, the Kansas Missouri. Showed them some Indian encampments, teepees. We even got attacked by a little war party, which I took care of promptly. So they thought they had a good time, and I took them back to the general. And darn if they didn't surprise me and give me two of these Navy Colts with a nickel plating and had my name engraved right there, James Butler Hickok. Carried those two with me. Rest of my life.